Hello and welcome to Family Outings TV. Today we're here at Blackpool Zoo. I've just got the bus from Blackpool Town Centre. Cost me £2.40, took about 20 minutes. And we're just going to go take a look. Come join me. So we've just entered Blackpool Zoo. The image before, you'll have just seen the prices. They do have adult prices, child prices, but they do also have group prices and disabled person prices. You'll have seen those in the screenshot just before this clip. Good first impression when you come into the theme park, as you can see behind me. I'll just flip the camera now. We're into a dinosaur area. We'll do a little walk through now and have a little look. So dinosaur safari just ahead. Do you call a dinosaur with no eyes? Do you think he saw us? What do you call a sleeping dinosaur? Dinosaurus? So that was the dinosaur safari. Really good for the kids. Probably about 15 different dinosaurs, maybe 20. Some with animatronics, noise, some that squirted water. If you're going around with kids, would have took you about maybe 20 minutes to get around that. So it was, yeah, it was good. My kids would have enjoyed it. We're now going to move on to the elephants and go have a look at them. Come join me. Right, so just been inside there into the elephant enclosure. Obviously there was just the one elephant out. It did look like quite a small area on the video footage, but I'm just going to do a flip. They do have obviously a massive outdoor area here that they might come out in if it's a bit warmer. It's not too bad today, but it is a cold temperature, I suppose, for October. I did see probably three or four elephants out the back that were hiding. So I'm not sure what the total amount of elephants they have here is, but yeah, as I say, they were all indoors, but there is plenty of space for them outdoors, as you've just seen. So now we're going to continue and we'll go find something else to have a look at. I know the sea lion show is at 11:50. I'm going to go and try and get some seats for that. And yeah, let's just go have a look, see what we can find. So just saw this as I was walking around the zoo. Meet a sea lion, get up close and personal for £10 per person. 3 to 17 year olds must be with an adult, under 3s are not able to do it, unfortunately. I think that's pretty good value, really, £10. Touch a sea lion. Right, so here we are at one of the looks like the biggest cafe here on site, Lakeside View Cafe. I'm going to flip the camera in a second, do a little tour, have a look at the prices, and see what the food looks like. Let's have a look at this cafe here. This just seems to be like the coffee area. There's no actual prices here. Let's go have a walk. Seems quite clean in here, quite spacious, but I would imagine at lunchtime it'll be very, very busy. Probably no seats available. There you go, that's quite good. Family meal deal, not sure if you can see that there. Two adult meals, two kids meals, £17.75. Some other things here. There we go, some of the food down here. Looks quite nice actually. Let's have a look at this. Refillable cups. So you've got £4.99 including refills, including drink refills, £1.50. So I'm guessing that's £6.50 if you want the cup with free refills, or £5 if you remember. And then you've got all your drinks, and then some lunch bags, some kids and adults lunch bags. So that's £3.95, £4.99, then sandwiches £3.75. The value seems a lot better in here than the kiosk that we looked at earlier, to be honest. I will get something for lunch from here, and then we can have a look at what the food looks like. There's another area over here. Let's have a look. This looks like a fast food area. So let's have a look what sort of things we've got here. Vegan burger meal, kids meal, hot dog meal, pizza meal. You're looking at from anything for the kids meal from £4 up to £15 for a 12-inch pizza meal for two. So a few different things there. Again, this one seems a little bit more expensive than the one I've just literally just been to there. But we'll have a look later. Let's have a look there. There's the prices. Just leaning over. Okay, we'll go to the last place in here. Well, look, he wants to be on the YouTube channel. Say hello.
Hello.
Hello. Right. This is one of the guests on our trips. We're staying at the Blackpool Gresham Hotel. Make sure he's on YouTube now. He'll love that. And then last but least, there's this place in here. It seems to do Starbucks and ice cream. You look at obviously Starbucks prices there. Large drinks, £3.90. And then your ice creams here. Looking around £2, £2.50 for your ice cream. So the food, the first part there of the food actually looked quite good value. The first area of the cafe, just one second while I sort this camera out. Yeah, the first area of the cafe looked like quite good value. The fast food places seem to be more expensive, which is strange, but we'll have a look at the food later and then see what we think in regards to value for money, because it's all right paying more if you think you're getting good value for money. So we'll have a look at that in a second. This is the view from the cafe. This is the outside seating area. It's actually quite warm for an October. Sun's coming out now. I might sit outside later, probably be the only one. But yeah, we'll continue. See, live show starts in about 45 minutes. So I'm gonna head over there soon, okay? So I've just gone there to the sea lion show to try and get a seat. Just saw a problem, hopefully it won't be a problem. I'm going to go back there in a second. But you've got the glass at the front and then you've got the seating behind. Now, I'm hoping that the staff members are going to make sure that the glass gets cleared so that people can't stand in front of the glass, so that the people on the seating area can't see. Does look like a bit of a problem to me, however, you never know. Let's go see what happens. Hopefully I'll get some good footage. I've just found this sneaky side area, which I'll probably just stay here instead, I think. Save taking the gamble.
We need our sea lion to be able to spot you today. And then when Gina gets to the top of that waterfall, we're gonna see if they have spotted you. And there we go, I think they have, because they're going to give you a big one.
Right, so there you have your clips there from the sea lion show. It was more of an informative show than kind of any sort of, you know, jumps out the water kind of thing. You'll have seen from the clips that the actual habitat itself is really nice. It's the best one I've ever seen for sea lions. Big, clean, seem to have a lot of props in there for the sea lions. So they're really well looked after, obviously. Yeah, it was more informative than any actual shows or jumps or tricks. Me personally, I do like the tricks and things, like the one at Flamingo Land, although their actual habitat is a lot smaller. I do like the actual show better. I don't know if that makes me a bad person, probably does. But yeah, I like the one at Flamingo Land better, because you've got them jumping out of water, doing more tricks and things, just showing kind of how clever they actually are. That was more about the body, how it works, and kind of their dangers in life, in the environment, kind of plastic and things like that, which is all very informative, very good. I'm just comparing it to the one in Flamingo Land, but yeah, definitely worth a watch. Kids again would enjoy it. And now we're just going to go and have I'm probably going to go get some lunch now, so we'll take some videos of lunch. And yeah, I've seen some play areas around the zoo, which is great if you've got kids with you. I'm going to take some videos of them as well, just to kind of see what you can do with the kids, just to fill some time in. I know with my kids sometimes they just want a break, sit down, have a cup of tea and let them play for 10-15 minutes, or I'll take some quick videos of them as well, okay? Here comes the train that goes around the park. This train, one of the stations is actually over by the penguin and sea lion area. You will get to see that on the map, which you saw at the beginning of the post. But you obviously do get the maps as you are entering the zoo as well. Just walking down here now, I'm not sure if there's a cost for this or whether it is included in the price. Oh yeah, there we go. So it's £1.50 per person that for a train ride, which again I just think it should be included in the price. If they want to charge people, they should just charge them as part of the entry, okay? So going into let's have a look what it's called. There's children's farm. This looks like a petting zoo. See what's in here, kind of things. It's October at the moment, so you've got pumpkins that you can buy and carve for £2. There's tables there with all the carving gear on. Little play area over here. And then let's have a look what else we've got. We've got sheep. Bunnies. Donkeys. Lots of donkeys. Goats. Ponies. And there's some alpacas at the back, over there in the distance. And there's my favourite, ready for me bacon sandwich tomorrow. Sorry if you're a vegan or a vegetarian. Hello. Oh yeah. Hiya! Ah, he's not playing. Hiya! And then we got some guinea pigs. So yeah, pretty cool. Kids will enjoy this. Right, so here we have my lunch, sausage, chips and beans. And a drink, which was £6.25, which is quite good value, can't knock it. Obviously it's very basic food. What I would say is, on the picture above the food kiosk, as you've seen earlier, it has a picture of three sausages, chips and beans, but I only got two sausages. Don't need three sausages, plenty here for me, but just find it funny how I would say three sausages when there's only two. The wallabies weren't playing, no good. Let's go check out the wolves. Aroo! Just the one wolf too. Not playing. Random bit alert and go.
That big.
What do you get when two giraffes collide? A giraffic jam? That's us done here at Blackpool Zoo for the day. Really good zoo, plenty of exhibitions, lots of things for the kids to do, like play areas in any sort of downtime. Food is about in line with the every single other attraction. Expensive, average quality, nothing amazing. I've been here since just after 10, and just let me just have a look at the time now. It is 2 o'clock. Obviously I'm by myself. If I was with my family, I would have went round a lot slower, so you could easily spend a day here with the family. It's really clean, the animals seem well looked after, so I would definitely come here with your family if you are in the area. As I say, the prices were at the beginning of the video. If you've liked this video, hopefully it has given you some insight into what Blackpool Zoo offers. If you do like this video, please like it and also subscribe to the channel. I believe that'll be about bottom right, about here, about now. Press that, subscribe, and there'll be more videos from more attractions coming soon. Thanks very much for watching, and we'll see you again soon. Bye!